The following program was provided by an independent producer solely responsible for its content. The opinions expressed do not necessarily represent the views of this station, its staff, board of directors, or underwriters.
My name is Rebecca Wilkie.
And my name is Hutch Mosley.
Welcome to Falcon News Network. Wow, December already. The first trimester is over. We started a new trimester on the 4th. Hope it will be a good one.
Breakfast is available each morning from 7:30 to 7:50. Please clean up your area.
Just a reminder that there is no bike riding or skating in the front of the school or in the parking lot. Please be safe.
Just a reminder from the nurse to everyone to dress appropriately for the weather.
We are hoping that Mr. Abergast is enjoying his new position here at FMS. Things are going well with him here.
Please join the PTO. All parents and friends are encouraged to join. Please contact Mrs. Mary Beth and McCarthy if you need more information.
The PTO sponsored a Yankee Candle sale, and we're so happy with the results. A big thank you to all who supported us.
As a matter of safety, we ask that you do not drop off your child in the bus loop in the morning. They can be dropped off at the entrance to the driveway and then walk up the sidewalk.
The FMS school store and library are both looking for more adult volunteers. The school store hours are 10:30 a.m. until 12:45 p.m. Days needed are Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. Library hours and days are flexible. Please contact Maribeth McCarthy at FMS.
Please remember the first bell rings at 7:50 and the other bell rings at 8. If you are not in your class by then, you are considered late.
Remember, the school store is open during most lunches. Get your school supplies there.
There are a few workshops for teachers and parents about ADHD. Myths and Facts was held in October at Nashua High School South. We hope the parents present this again.
Do you want an FMS t-shirt, sweatshirt, or joggers, or other gear to show your school spirit? Check out the school links and the school store.
Dr. Mosley had a parent focus group at Nashua High School South. He's very interested in to hear thoughts on what schools do well and where we can improve. Your feedback is always important.
The Wildcats team held a Halloween bake sale on Monday, October 29th to raise funds for our December field trip. They had some great treats.
The FMS movie group canceled due to the snowstorm. I bet for a lot of kids were disappointed about the missing movie, but I'm glad for the snow day.
Federal Lunch Program. A reminder to all families who yet to reapply for the Federal Lunch Program. Please reapply as soon as possible. Paper applications are available in the office at your school. Or call Doreen Burgess.
There will be a geotech meeting on Thursday in the library after school.
Sixth graders had their fall Halloween social and had a great turnout. The seventh grade fall social also canceled due to the snow, but will be rescheduled in the spring.
Snow days will be announced on WSMN and the local TV stations and robocall.
The drama club's show, a parody on Shakespeare, was a great hit. All the shows were sold out and the actors were amazing. A big thank you to our director, Miss G and Miss I, for their time and their support.
If you are looking for a job, please check out our school websites.
A big thank you to our janitor, Mr. Joe P, for always helping us out.
The Tiger team went to the Seacoast Service Center to learn about the Rocky Shores. They had a great time.
The Wolf Pack went to Mount Monadnock for a hike, even in the rain. The kids had a great time. The Wolf Pack are also doing an interesting science project on buildings. Hope they display them for all to see.
The Fighting Irish and the Pirates went to Patriots Nation in Boston and saw so many interesting things about football and Patriots.
There was a presentation for parents and staff on Tuesday, November 13th by Breath New Hampshire on vaping and the dangers. I think students should see that also.
The library had a Scholastic Book Fair and it did very well.
The Student Council held a great fundraiser during the election and sold fresh rice, fresh Krispy Kreme donuts to voters and staff.
The American Mathematics Competition for middle school was on November 13th. We are still waiting for results.
There was a craft fair at FMS and a community resource fair at FES in October.
Mrs. Edward is pleased to announce that there is a special middle school art show at Nashua Public Library. In the show presentations the best of the middle schools. Artists, there are 12 students chosen from FMS. Congratulations to the winners.
There was a presentation by Mr. Ed Garrity for all the eighth graders, and the students really enjoyed the presentation.
The teachers had a seminar on Learn and Lead and Innovate in November at Nashua High School South.
A big congratulations to Ms. Little from the FMS for winning the Teacher of the Year award.
Red Ribbon Week was a great success. A big thanks to our guidance counselors.
DECA held an expo in the school cafeteria, and it was a very well turnout at event. The students had some very interesting ideas.
We would also like to congratulate Mrs. Rachel Brindley for being promoted Master Sergeant in the United States Air Force.
The Veterans Day Assembly was very special. Thank you to Ms. Natalie LaFlamme for organizing such a wonderful event. The chorus and band were wonderful.
The EOL Ambassador Program is back. So glad to have that again.
The Irish team, once again, under Ms. Ferran's guidance, put flags on veterans' graves here in Nashua.
There was a free workshop for teachers and parents about life beyond high school. If you missed it, contact Valerie Morse for information. They have another one.
STEM Day for the 8th grade girls was a success. The girls were engaged and interested.
FMS has organized the donations of over 100 Thanksgiving dinners to families in the school networks with the help of our partner Gate City Community Collection. The families will receive a turkey, fresh veggies, and the fixing for sides dishes.
Miss Pitt's Pizzas and the music department held auditions for Annie Jr. just recently. Auditions have been over, and there was no callbacks, and the cast list will be posted on Friday. Good luck to all.
Our 41st president, H.W. Bush, has passed away.
The L class had its annual Molecular Thanksgiving Fest. It is a time to celebrate our diversity and thankfulness as they learn about this American holiday. The celebrations include conversation about what we are thankful for and food from all over the world.
The Pirate Team is bringing team meetings to the 7th grade. The newest twist of team meetings is that they will be run by students instead of teachers. More on this later.
Morning sports is up and running. Students from all grade levels gather together each morning at 7 a.m. to play sports. Students run the games, and everyone is welcome regardless of athletic ability. If you are interested, see Miss Natalie LaFlamme for a permission slip.
The Drama Club cast party will be held on December 19th. Please return in your money and permission slips to Miss G.
A big shout out to the high school DECA students for helping out the DECA students in middle school.
Some Irish students participated in the Generation Global International video conference on November 27th. Our partnering schools were Special School and Ukraine and Poland.
On Monday, November 26th, the NASA InSight lander touched down on Mars. How exciting! You can still catch the broadcast on NASA.org.
There'll be a free sports clinic at Nashua High School South on lacrosse and field hockey for girls. See Miss Rolfe.
If you have any school news that you would like to report to Miss to, that you would like to report, see the news crew or send it to Miss G.
The Irish team and pirate team will be attending the Christmas Carol play in Manchester in December.
Registrations for ski club will be closing December 12th. Get your slips or see Miss Flanagan.
Interested in going to New York? If you are, see Miss Carrie in the library for more information.
Yearbook club has started. See Miss Carrie for more information.
Prep rally will be coming up the last week before vacation. Get your team colors ready.
The walk-in pets presentation will be coming on Friday, January 11th.
Congratulations to the chorus and band for the great concerts.
Report cards will be going home on Monday, December 10th. This has been Rebecca Wilkie
and Hutch Mosley
with your school news.
Hi, my name is Marissa Abbas.
And my name is Emma McBorney.
And we're here to give you the great debate. Today we're going to be debating whether schools should make up snow days.
I think that we should make up snow days.
And I think that we shouldn't make up snow days.
Let me start with one of my reasons. If kids live in cold places and they get tons of snow, then they will be missing a lot of school time that they need to have. That way they are able to learn everything that they need to learn for the school day. If we don't make up snow days, then we won't have enough time to learn everything that we need to learn for the school year.
My turn. Many families need to make their plans for summer vacation ahead of time. Some families might need to cancel their vacation plans. Some families might even need to take their kids out early, and that stinks because everybody knows that the last week of school is always super fun.
Let me give you another opinion. Even if we don't make up whole days, we should just add time to the already existing school days.
Well, think of it like this. Many students have after-school activities and that aren't involved with the school, so they would have to completely reschedule them or just stop taking them.
But to get all of the hours and time that we need for school to be able to learn everything that we need to know, then we need to make up snow days.
This is my final thought. Let's be honest, we really don't need to do anything in the last 2 weeks of school. We just clean, talk to our old teachers, and sign each other's yearbooks. Watch movies, and teachers finish putting in our final grades.
Fine. This is my final thought. Some school districts don't use days to keep track of how much time we spent at school. They use hours. So maybe we could get to work to do at home in case we get a snow day.
Let's agree to disagree.
Fine, but what do you think? This has been Emma McBorney
and Marissa Abbas
with the Great Debate.
Hi, I'm Audra Hamlin.
And I'm Madison Roscoe.
And we're here to bring you some fun facts. I'll go first. Did you know McDonald's once made bubblegum flavored broccoli in order to get kids to eat healthier?
That sounds gross. Did you know the letter Q is not in any U.S. state name?
That's crazy. Here's another crazy one. Scotland has 421 words for snow.
And I thought we had a lot of words for snow. Here's another weather one. Did you know that the Windy City name has nothing to do with Chicago's weather? It actually was given by the reporter who thought the residents of Chicago were full of hot air.
This one is mind-blowing. Peanuts aren't technically nuts. They're legumes.
Whoa, that's a cool one. Armadillo shells are bulletproof.
I don't want to mess with an armadillo. Did you know the longest English word has 189,819 letters? It's some kind of fancy scientific protein.
I hope that word's never on a spelling test. This one's an animal fact. Did you know that octopuses lay 56,000 eggs at a time?
That's crazy. Here's another animal fun fact. Did you know cats have fewer toes on their back paws than their front?
Here's one last animal fact. Blue whales eat 500,000 calories in one mouthful.
That's crazy. Get this. The tiny pockets in your jeans were actually designed to store pocket watches.
I always thought those were for loose change. This one's weird. The man with the world's deepest voice makes sounds that humans can't hear.
Whoa, that's crazy. This one proves that kids can make a difference too. The current American flag was designed by a high school student.
That's inspiring. Get this. Only a quarter of the Sahara Desert is sandy. Most of it's gravel and mountains and oases.
This one is dedicated to all the dog lovers out there. Dogs smell good smells with their left nostril.
Interesting. This one's a little stinky. The word fizzle originally meant a type of fart.
Ew, that does stink. This one is cool. You only have two body parts that never stop growing. Your nose and your ears.
That's cool. This one is weird. Movie trailers originally played after the movie.
What's the point of that? This is also weird. Theodore Roosevelt had a pet hyena.
This one goes to all the cereal lovers out there. Captain Crunch's full name is Horatio Maglin Crunch.
Last one. Giraffes' tongues can be up to 20 inches long.
As Audra said, I think we're done here. This is Madison Roscoe.
And Audra Hamblin.
With your fun facts.
Hello, my name is Bob Bollinger with The Hot Seat. Today we'll be interviewing Jared Barbosa, the guidance counselor of FMS Middle School. I just repeated myself, but that's fine. Would you like to give us a little showcase about your background?
About my background? Yeah. Sure. Yeah. I've been with Fairgrounds going on the second year.
Nice.
As a guidance counselor, prior to that, I was at Amherst Street. Amherst Street Elementary School as a guidance counselor, and before that, I was at a middle school in Goffstown called Mountain View Middle School. It's been great being here, and I look forward to more years.
Oh, that's very nice. So do you have any children? Are you married?
Yes.
Yes. Tell us about that.
Married to my absolute soulmate, Sarah. I met her when I was working at the Boys and Girls Club. And we have two lovely boys, Monty Rain Barbosa, who's 1.5, and Luca Stone Barbosa, who's 5.
Very nice. Mm-hmm. Do you have any pets? And if you don't, which animal do you prefer, dogs or cats?
Dogs. And we have both a dog and a cat. Our cat's name is Prince. My wife loved the late Prince. And our dog is Brewster.
Oh, very nice.
Yeah.
So, if you didn't get a job as a guidance counselor from FMS, what do you think your job would be right now?
Oh, that's a good question. What would I do right now? I see myself, if it wasn't at FMS, maybe being a teacher or coaching soccer somewhere.
Oh, so you do soccer?
Yes, yeah.
Mm-hmm. What's the team?
Well, I run my own, we run a soccer organization called International Soccer Club. I'm the CEO of it. So we have youth clubs, so we have over 10 teams for youth age groups, and we have a pro team as well, and we also do a little program for three-year-olds, so just cute.
Oh, so that's for almost all ages.
All ages, yes.
Very
yes.
Nice.
Yep.
So I know you work as a guidance counselor, but since I know you'd be dealing. Okay, so basically, what I'm trying to say is, would you have worked as maybe like a psychologist if you weren't a guidance counselor?
No. I just was never really interested in going that route. I always felt that guidance was a perfect fit. Gives me a little bit of I like psychology, but I really think that being a guidance counselor is right in the middle. So I didn't want to go too much with the psych stuff, but I wanted just a little bit of it. But I also really wanted to work with kids within a school.
Okay.
Yeah.
So do you think this will be your permanent job before you retire?
No, it won't. I have aspirations to I'm going back to school to get my administration.
Oh, that's very nice.
Yeah. So, trying to move up. That's all.
Very interesting. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So, do you think you would have tried? Do you think you're going to try to like be maybe a teacher if after this?
No, not a teacher, but hopefully down the line an assistant principal or principal.
Let's hope so.
Yeah.
Thank you. This has been Bob Bonger with our lovely guest, Jared Barbosa. This has been Bob Bonger with The Hot Seat.
Hi, I'm Lindsay Hovey with your reviews.
And my name is Seth Greenberg, and I'm bringing you our FMS sports information.
The two books teens are reading are The Cruel Prince by Holly Black, by the number one New York Times bestseller, and Before I Let You Go by Mary Nickamp, I think. And then the two movies are Eighth Grade and The Kissing Booth. The two songs are Girls Like You by Maroon 5 and Better Now, Post Malone.
And here's our sports information. Morning sports is going strong. The games start at 7 a.m. and finish about 7:40 a.m. The games for the day are posted on the office window and by the gym. The winter sports registration has ended, and teams have been picked for cheerleaders, girls and boys basketball, and wrestling. Good luck to all. The FMS Ski Club says to think snow. Biddy and Bantam basketball have started, and you can catch the games on Fridays and Saturdays at FMS. Here are some scores for our fall sports. For the boys' middle school basketball team, they lost at the Parkside Middle School 44-45. At the Milford Middle School, they lost by 52-73. And at the Windham Middle School, they also lost at 34-44. For the girls' basketball, they won against Parkside by 36-29. And at the Milford Middle School, they won by 30-19. And they lost at the Windham Middle School by 43-46. Congrats to our favorite baseball team, the Red Sox, for winning the World Series. This has been Seth Greenberg with the latest in sports. Go Falcons!
The preceding program was provided by an independent producer solely responsible for its content. The opinions expressed do not necessarily represent the views of this station, its staff, board of directors, or underwriters.